There is peace in Christ when we learn of Him. Feel the love He felt for us when He bore our sins. Listen to His words, let them come alive. If we know Him as He is, there is peace in Christ.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Our scripture reading for today is taken from Mark 9, verse 42. If anyone causes one of these little ones, those who believe in me, to stumble, it would be better for them if a large millstone were hung around their neck and they were thrown into the sea. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Our message for today is from Mark chapter 9, verse 42. And as we come to this chapter, we come to a section marked by warning. Jesus is offering warnings that drive home what is really at stake when it comes to sin and the consequences of the sin. To follow Jesus is a highly calling and a costly calling. But for those who reject Him and remain in their sin, the cost is much higher. In chapter 9, verse 42, the warning is about our relationship with others. And here, Jesus uses a child to illustrate the kind of people we are to serve in this world. We are to serve those that are neglected and rejected by others. We are to serve those who cannot serve us in return. In other words, we are not to serve others so that we can be promoted. We are to willingly take the place of a slave in the kingdom of Christ, serving Christ by humbly serving our fellow man. In this verse, Jesus uses the same child to teach us another important principle. Not only are we to serve the least amongst us willingly, we are also commanded to protect the least amongst us from sin. Jesus says that it is a very serious matter when we cause one of God's children to fall into sin. He says that you would be better off having a millstone tied around your neck and being cast into the sea. The word translated millstone literally means a donkey stone. It refers to a stone used to grind grain that was so heavy that a donkey was tied to it to turn it. If such a stone were tied around the neck of an individual and that person was thrown into the sea, that person would be pulled to the bottom and they would drown. When Jesus used this image, his listeners were very familiar with what he said. On more than one occasion, the Romans had carried out executions by tying heavy stones around the necks of their victims and throwing them into rivers and lakes. The image is very graphic, and Jesus is describing a death that is horrible and as horrible as anyone can imagine. Yet he says it would be preferable for a person to die this way than for them to cause one of his little ones to fall into sin. Jesus says that this is a grievous sin. In fact, the person who harms one of his children is actually harming the Lord himself. So how do believers cause others to stumble? There are many ways. One of these is by directing and tempting others to sin. This kind of behavior can be seen throughout the Bible, and a typical example is Adam and Eve. People can be led into sin indirectly as well. And this is when we treat others in insensitive and unloving ways and unkind ways. We can cause them to sin through rebellion. We can spark an angry reaction in people, or we can cause them to throw up their hands in frustration. People can be led into sin by a wicked example. So here, if a believer who is weak in the faith sees a respected believer commit a sin, that younger believer would fall into sin by following that evil example. People can be led into sin because other believers fail to lead them into righteousness. In other words, we fail to share the riches of Christ with new believers. We fail to disciple them, and as a result, they remain weak and never grow up in the Lord. We fail to give them the spiritual food they need, and they starve in the midst of plenty. People can be led away through false doctrine as well, where teachers of false religion lead people astray. When they do this, they are committing a twofold sin. Firstly, they sin because they follow false religion, and secondly, they sin because they lead others and those that follow them away into hell. God says that the person who offends his little ones is in big trouble. Whether we see it or not, this is a very serious warning. There's a warning about the saints. So, while Jesus is giving us a warning in the scripture, we can take out of it a positive command. The call of this verse is to take care of and guard those who could be led astray. Amen.
perfect wisdom of our God, revealing all the universe, all things created by His hand and held together at His command. He knows the mysteries of the seas, the secrets of the stars are His. He guides the planets on their way and turns the earth through another day. Wisdom of His ways that mark the path of righteousness. His word a lamp unto my feet, His Spirit teaching and guiding me. And all the mystery of the cross, that God should suffer for to Christ. Of Your sovereignty. Each strand of sorrow has a place within this tapestry of grace. So through the trials I choose to say Your perfect will in Your perfect way. Each strand of sorrow has a place of grace. So through the trials I choose to say Your perfect will in Your perfect way.
Let us pray. Faithful Father, You remain trustworthy despite our failures and our unfaithfulness. You are always dependable, and it's not because of what we have done, but because that is who You are. Help us, Lord, to take that fully to heart. Help us place our full trust and dependence on You. We seek and trust You for wisdom and direction in every decision and every endeavor we take. Give us the wisdom and help us to renew our commitment to You. And keep us from all that would distract us or others from perceiving Your mercy and Your grace. In Jesus' name, amen.